Well, well, well. Afternoon, VivaMK. Fantastic to be here again and to give you a business update. And today, I'm going to reveal to you, of course, the next catalogue, because, hey, it's been at least 2 weeks since I told you about the new catalogue, so I will tell you all about that today and show you the front cover of that too. So, you've noticed the title I've put in today as Value Validation and VivaMK. I'm quite been talking a lot about validation lately, and it's really important to me that I've always believed that no one, and I mean absolutely no one has the power to tell you what to do, make you feel inferior, or validate you. No one has that power. I know this is not about coaching and it's not a personal development live update, but it's just important that we sometimes get these things out, that, you know, don't ever believe that any single person ever has the power to tell you what to do. How can they tell you what to do? Certainly not to make you feel inferior, and definitely not to validate you. And like I posted not so long ago, you know, if you are looking for validation from others, you are never ever going to feel less than inferior, because you're looking in the wrong place. All validation and recognition and validation is in here. So it's important that we just understand that. I know this isn't about personal development, but I know I like to get these things out every now and again. So like I said, no one has the power to tell you what to do, to make you feel inferior and validate you. No one has the power. I don't care who they are. I don't care what the argument is. It just does not happen. So we are now in the time and era where we have to be strong. Every individual has to be strong. You have to be yourself and do things the way you want to do them. And of course, most importantly, and another really important thing that's close to my heart, is be an encourager. If you can encourage somebody to do better or be better, then do it. Because like you've always heard, the world has got too many critics and discouraging people already. So be an encourager, be yourself, and be strong. You know, strong enough to make sure that somebody doesn't have power over you to tell you what to do, that they can't make you feel inferior, and that you do not need somebody to validate you. Like I said, it's not about personal development, but it's important in an industry like ours. You know where I stand on these things, and I will never change my opinion on that. And you know, I'd like to think that many of you believe in that also. So be strong, be yourself, and encourage people. Our business is about encouraging people. You know, Lynn McDonald put a webinar on last week. Over 40 people joined it on a Wednesday night, and you know, Ali and Jeff did their usual brilliant training. But that's what I call encouraging. That's what I call encouraging not only the business, but individuals. Now, there's another one on Wednesday, 19th of June. If you can join it, if you can watch it, then please do, because these things are put on to help encourage you and to help grow you and to help you make money. And the guest speaker on this one is going to be the fantastic Sharon Davis. You know, what Sharon doesn't know about building business and building network isn't worth knowing. You need to tune in. Lynn will put the link on here soon. Wednesday, 19th of June, Sharon Davis, you know, one of our most prolific people in the business and had success from day one. Always been an encourager, and I love that. Anybody that I see is an encourager with no ulterior motive is always good for me. And I always used to say that one of the most incredible things about a good network marketing organization was to see people support people cross-line. You know, if you have no vested interest in somebody and you still support them, that is phenomenal. Those are the people you want around you. So make sure you tune into that. Now, of course, now the outdoors catalogue, I'm talking about catalogues and things, the outdoor catalogue is finally out there and it has started to perform. Although the way I see it, outdoors is the last place anybody currently wants to be. But nevertheless, it's out there and it's working. So we'll get fuller penetration of that in the coming weeks and we'll get some real good results from that. So that, you know, was it's a great departure for us, some great products in there, some great niche products, and of course, attracting a different market. But you know, like I've said before, I'm going to stop giving timelines and catalogues because I got it so wrong. My mistake, you know, we're probably a month late with that, but now it's out there. It's no point looking back. Let's look forward on that. So talking of new catalogues and products, first let me hit this one straight on. You know, if you have found that you've put orders in and there's a handful of products or more than a handful of products that aren't in stock, you know, it's simply down to supply chain challenges. And we have been having them and we will have them, but we'll also sort them out and deal with them. And you will from time to time put an order in and you'll find that there's items missing, and it is frustrating, of course it is. Frustrating for you, of course, frustrating for your customer, and I know I'm stating the obvious, but frustrating for the company as well. Nobody wants anything that is no longer available. Nobody wants anything that is out of stock. Not you, not your customer, not us. Why would we? Because all across the board, people lose money when things aren't available. So when things aren't available, something is out of stock, there's usually a damn good reason behind it. And there can be a number of reasons. So whatever that supply chain challenges, and you're always going to have it when you've got over 1300 products. It's very difficult to keep on top of every single one of them, which is quite contradictory because in a moment I'm going to tell you about more products, but nevertheless, that's not the point. The point is that with so many products, there will be challenges at times. So if you've witnessed that, I do apologize. We're dealing with that in this supply chain challenges, and we will deal with that. It's not a terminal challenge. It's always a temporary challenge. Even when you see something that may not have been around from the beginning, there will be a valid reason, because can you imagine, why would a company want that? Why would a company want something that's just not available? Why would a distributor want that? And certainly not a customer. So all around, it doesn't help. But all around, you can imagine that we're always trying to deal with it and whatever the cause in that challenge. So on the basis of that, I've already said we've got 1,300 products. Now, this is not about introducing a huge, bigger glut of products, because you can only manage so many. And, you know, we haven't even been operation in a year. I always promised you 1,000 products by August 2019. We've got those. But what we want to do now is try to hone in and have the best 1,000 products, the things that sell the most. So I think one of the most prolific and successful catalogues we've had to date was, of course, the basics catalogue, giving people exactly what they need and when they need it, in the hope that they would see the basics and then buy across your range and create a better connection with you, because you're now providing some of the basics things that they really wanted or they really need. So on that theme, of course, I've always said to you that we will release another basics production, just to make sure that the customers are not only getting things they didn't think they wanted, but things that they do always need to help keep your connection and the flow going. So on the basis of that, and I refuse to give a timeline because I always get them wrong. So what I'll do today is simply tell you that there is a new basics coming. I won't give you the timeline just yet, but that's basically what it's going to be. And what we've done with this one, if you just have a look at that, then I'll waffle through it afterwards. So what we've done with this is we've incorporated, which was the obvious thing to do, some of the essential products with the basic products and giving you a bigger and brighter catalogue that will hit the elements of everything people need. So this will be the form, almost like the basics mixed in with everything else. So if you can see, that's it's going to have that same brightness about it. It's going to have that same brashness about it. But this was a very successful catalogue for us when we launched it back in March. So this, I will give you dates when I'm very certain about when it's going to be, which will be over the next couple of weeks, and I'll show you some of the products that are going to be in there. There will be some innovation of products, but generally it will be basics in just in a different format with some extra products. But like I said, you know, you can't keep building and building and building your product portfolio. What you do is you test and see what works best, then hone it in to the ones that are selling the most. There's no point keeping SKUs or products that just aren't selling. So that is coming soon. I just wanted to say that we're always working on new productions. I mean, the basics wasn't that difficult. Well, I shouldn't say that because everything takes time and effort to put together. But with that, it just goes back to your customers to give them what they want as well as what they think they might need where the other catalogues are concerned. So I'll give you dates on that in the coming weeks or so and tell you exactly when it's going to be around. And I'll show you some inside pages. I'll show you how we've moved on from the basic that came back out in March, but it's a big successful catalogue for us, and I do believe that one will be as well. And the idea always is that people open that, they get the really basic things that they may want, and from that your connection is greater and they look at the other catalogues and then they increase their spend in what they want. So that's coming soon, and that's really just to show you that we're constantly working on those. And I've always said I'll try and give you a run of catalogues and tell you what's happening when. Now, in our first year, the one thing that we always wanted to do to see what kind of time scales and see what kind of timings a catalogue should have. There's obvious ones. Christmas is going to be the 31st of August. I've always said that. Be at the showcase, you'll get your first preview of that to build the last part of the year. In between that, wherever else is happening, and I've promised you various things, I'll keep you updated on that in the coming weeks. There will be other things happening, which of course includes that too. So that's products. Now, people keep talking to me about other products from other businesses. I need to address this again. You know, I know it feels like I address it all the time, but it's so necessary. You know, somebody will write to me and say, oh, they've found a great bunion cream. I don't know why I chose that in particular. It just came to mind. I found a great bunion cream in another company. Can I use it? What the hell are you asking me for? If you find a product that you like, use it. You know, next you'll be asking me if you can watch Love Island or not. I don't know why I said that either. But nevertheless, if you find a product you like, of course you should use it. Of course you can use it. That is not even a question that you should be asking me, but I appreciate why you're asking, because there used to be this ethos that you just do not use products from other companies. But that is history. We don't work like that anymore. You know, I had the three V's there. I had validation, which I've covered. I've talked about value, which is adding value to what the customer offering is, and VivaMK in general. The one thing I missed from there was the other V, because I didn't want it to sound negative, was vultures. We always will have other companies and their vultures hovering around. That's not the ethos that I want in VivaMK. Our ethos isn't to hover around, sniffing around people's inboxes, trying to get them into the business. That's not how we work, and please don't ever work like that. To date, I can be honest with you that I don't know anybody in our organization that has acted like a vulture. You know, and these vultures from other organizations, it's an old type of network marketing ethos where, you know, originally it was about people and connecting people and encouraging people. Then you will always get a minority that try to poach people from other organizations. I don't want to talk too much about it, but, you know, they will kind of use anything. You know, they'll watch last week's broadcast and say, hey, you don't want to be part of VivaMK. The MD doesn't even wear trousers when he's doing an FB Live. You know, they'll pick on anything and everything. You know, if they want something, I'll give them a lot more than that. But nevertheless, you know, let us not be like that. That's my point. There will always be vultures. You know, I know there will be, because I get them myself. You know, people I haven't spoke to for ages suddenly turn up, and before I know it, you know, I'm being offered an opportunity of some variety. So, you know, you're always going to get it, because we in industries like this are also valuable in what we do. You know, some of the people in our business today are so valuable to the industry. Of course the vultures are going to be hovering. Of course they're going to be lurking and sniffing around your inboxes. Of course they're going to want you in their business. Why wouldn't they? It's human nature to do that. My point is, irrespective of that, that can't be stopped, and they will pick on anything and everything to peddle their business. My point is, let us never ever be that. Let's go back to that original ethos that I keep talking about, the ethos of encouraging people, the ethos of it is supporting people, the ethos of simply connecting people and showing them how to make money in a simple everyday business. And you know, that connection is the part that has been so much missing in so many parts of the industry. It has become such a vulturistic, there's no such word as vulturistic, but a vulturistic industry that it, as I've said before, it gets scathing attacks in the media, and I don't want us to be part of that. I don't want to be one of the companies that gets attacked by the media saying that, you know, they have this vulturistic way about them, that they look for people's vulnerabilities to get them in their organization. We're never going to be like that. I don't care what the others do. So yes, feel free to use whatever products you want to use, but thank you for, you know, your honesty and your credibility and just asking first. You know, if you have bunions and some other company sells a great bunion cream or oil, hey, go ahead and use it. It's your feet. And just don't ever become like some of the others that do that kind of behavior. We have so much going on in our business. Let's concentrate on our business. And like I said at the beginning, no one, but no one has the power to tell you what to do, to make you feel inferior, I don't care who it is, and to validate you. Validate yourself. The recognition that you want and need is already in there, so validate yourself. But along the way, always find time to encourage people. Always find time to help build people. And if it means doing it within the business by offering them the opportunity, fantastic. Let's offer the opportunity to as many people as we can, but always validating yourself and encouraging people to be better than they are. So we've talked about catalogues, and just back one more time, you know, if there are supply chain challenges, of course we'll be dealing with those constantly, as well as trying to build the facets of the business that I know always work so well. In the coming weeks, I'll give you dates on that, dates when I'm absolutely sure about them, because we know how wrong I got it with the outdoors catalogue. And then we'll start talking more in the coming weeks about, of course, our forthcoming showcase, which is on the 31st of August, and it's a gala dinner too, as you know. It's titled Don't Stop Me Now, because at the end of the day, no, don't stop me now, because of course I'm here to build this business with the people that want to build it with me. Most of us are pioneers. We're doing this for the first time from a proper ground floor opportunity, which means, yes, we have all the pitfalls, but we have all the opportunities too to actually become one of the best businesses in the UK. And again, it's not necessarily about that, but it's about keeping the ethos of connection, of partnership, of working together and being encouragers and not being vulturistic. Thank you for listening once again, and I'll catch you very soon. Thank you. Bye.